Hello dear students, in this video we will prove the theorem of angle sum property of triangle, and we will also apply the property to solve some questions. The statement of the theorem is: prove that the sum of angles of a triangle is 180 degrees. Let us assume we are given a triangle by name ABC with vertices A, B and C, and we need to prove that the sum of these angles, the interior angles of triangle ABC, angle A plus angle B plus angle C, is equals to 180 degrees. So in order to prove this, we'll have to do a construction, and the construction will be drawing a line parallel to one of the sides of the triangle ABC. Here, we are drawing a line XY through vertice A such that it is parallel to side BC of triangle. We could also have drawn a line through B such that it would have been parallel with AC, or a line through the vertice C such that the line drawn would have been parallel with AB. We have decided we will draw a line XY through A such that it is parallel with side BC. Now, let us label angle A as angle 1, angle B as angle 2, angle C as angle 3. We are doing it for the sake of convenience, as after the construction, after drawing line XY parallel with BC, we have multiple angles by the name A. We have angle XAB, we have angle BAC as the original interior angle of the triangle, and we have angle YAC. So in order to remove the confusion, we have numbered the angles. The construction of XY parallel to BC has given us two more angles around angle A, and let us name the angles adjacent to angle A as angle 4 and angle 5. Here, since XY is parallel to BC, we will have angle 4 equals to angle 2 and angle 5 equals to angle 3, as these are alternate angles. Let us label them as equation number 1 and equation number 2. Now further, we will have the sum of angle 1, angle 4 and angle 5 as 180 degrees. Angle 1 plus angle 4 plus angle 5 equals to 180 degrees, as the sum of these three angles is giving us a straight angle. So the measure of a straight angle is 180 degrees. Now using equation 1 and 2, we can write angle 2 in place of angle 4 as they are equal from equation 1. And in place of 5, angle 5, we can write angle 3 from equation number 2. So we will get angle 1 plus angle 2 in place of angle 4 from equation 1 plus angle 3 in place of angle 5 from equation 2 equals to 180 degrees. Now we can replace them with the actual vertices. Angle A plus angle B plus angle C equals to 180 degrees. So the theorem has been proved, and this theorem is angle sum property of triangle. Now we will apply the property to solve some questions. The first question: in the given figure, sides QP and RQ of triangle PQR are produced to points S and T respectively if angle SPR equals to 135 degrees and angle PQT equals to 110 degrees, we need to find the value of angle PRQ. So let's write the given first. Triangle PQR. Side QP has been produced to point S and angle SPR is equals to 135 degree. Further, it is also given to us that side RQ has been produced to point T and the measure of angle PQT is equals to 110 degree. We need to find the value of angle PRQ inside the triangle PQR. So, the angle that is adjacent to angle SPR is forming a linear pair. So, in order to make it more convenient, let us label it as angle 1, the angle QPR as angle 1. Here, angle SPR and angle 1 are forming a linear pair. So, angle SPR plus angle 1 will be equals to 180 degree because of linear pair. Now, putting the value of angle SPR, 135 degree plus angle 1 is equals to 180 degree. Now, taking 135 degree to the other side, we will have angle 1 equals to 180 degree minus 135 degree. On doing the subtraction, we will get angle 1 equals to 45 degree. Similarly, let's label the angle adjacent to angle PQT as angle 2. And we will have the sum of angle PQT and angle 2 equals to 180 degree because of property of linear pair of angles. Putting the value of PQT, we will get 110 degree plus angle 2 equals to 180 degree. Taking 110 to the other side, we will get angle 2 equals to 180 degree minus 110 degree. So, the value of angle 2 is 70 degree. So, inside triangle PQR, we have got the value of angle 1 and angle 2. Now, we can easily find the value of the third angle, that is angle PRQ. Now, in triangle PQR, angle PRQ plus angle 1 plus angle 2 will be equals to 180 degree because of angle sum property of triangle. Let's put the values of angle 1 and angle 2, which are 45 degree and 70 degree respectively. Angle PRQ plus 45 degree plus 70 degree is equals to 180 degree. Angle PRQ plus 115 degree equals to 180 degree. Now let's take 115 degree to the other side. We will get angle PRQ equals to 180 degree minus 115 degree. On doing the subtraction, angle PRQ is equals to 65 degree. So we have got the value of the required angle, angle PRQ as 65. Now the next question. In the given figure, angle X is equals to 62 degree. Angle XYZ is equals to 54 degree. If YO and ZO are the bisectors of angle XYZ and angle XZY respectively, then we need to find the values of angle OZY and angle YOZ. So let's list the given criterions first. Given to us is angle X equals to 62 degree and angle XYZ is equals to 54 degree. These two angles are the angles which can be located inside the bigger triangle, triangle XYZ. So let's evaluate triangle XYZ first. In triangle XYZ, the values of the two interior angles are known to us. That means the value of the third interior angle can be known quite easily. We will have in triangle XYZ, angle X plus angle XYZ plus the unknown angle, angle XZY equals to 180 degree. because of angle-sum property of triangle. Putting the values, the known values, 62 degree for angle X plus 54 degree for angle XYZ plus angle XZY equals to 180 degree. 62 plus 54 will be 116 degree plus angle XZY equals to 180 degree. Taking 116 degree to the other side, we will get angle XZY equals to 180 degree minus 116 degree. On doing the subtraction, angle XZY is equals to 64 degree. So we've got the value of the third interior angle of the bigger triangle, triangle XYZ. It is also given to us that YO is the bisector of angle XYZ. That means YO will divide angle XYZ into two parts and the magnitude of both the parts will be equal. So, the two parts of angle XYZ will be angle OYX and angle OYZ. Since YO is the bisector of angle XYZ, we will have angle OYX equals to angle OYZ equals to half of angle XYZ. Both will get half of angle XYZ. Angle OYX equals to angle OYZ equals to half into 54 degree, the value of angle XYZ. 227 is 54. So we will have angle OYX equals to angle OYZ equals to 27 degree. Also, ZO is the bisector of angle XZY. So, ZO will now divide angle XZY into two parts such that the magnitude of both the parts will be equal. The two parts will be angle OZX and angle OZY, and both will be half of angle XZY. OZX equals to OZY equals to half into 64 degree. 232 will be 64. So, angle OZX equals to angle OZY equals to 32 degree. Remember, we had to find the values of angle OZY and angle YOZ as per the question. We have already got the value of angle OZY, and that is equals to 32 degree. So, angle OZY equals to 32 degree. Now, in order to find the value of angle YOZ, we will shift our focus to the smaller triangle, triangle YOZ. In triangle YOZ, the three interior angles are angle YOZ, angle OYZ, and angle OZY. The sum of these three angles will be equals to 180 degree because of angle sum property of triangle. The values of angle OYZ and OZY are known to us now. So, we will put their values here and then derive the value of angle YOZ. We will get angle YOZ plus 27 degree in place of angle OYZ plus 32 degree in place of angle OZY equals to 180 degree. Sum of 27 degree plus 32 degree will be 59 degree. So, angle YOZ plus 59 degree equals to 180 degree. Now, taking 59 degree towards the right hand side, we will get angle YOZ equals to 180 degree minus 59 degree. On doing the subtraction, we will get angle YOZ equals to 121 degree. So, we got the value of angle YOZ as well. Now, do these questions on your own for your assignment. Thank you and have a nice day.